Hey Libra, this is your girl D with Hidden Truth Tarot, bringing you your May 15th through May 31st love reading. Hope you guys are doing okay. I hope all is well. And I want to make sure that I get you the message from the divine so that you guys will have some insight into your love and relationships situation between May 15th. May 31st. Any of you guys who celebrate Memorial Day, I hope you enjoy your Memorial Day. Hopefully you'll have a lot of fun and or relaxation with friends and family or loved ones. I am new to YouTube. This is my first Libra video. So please feel free to let me know how things resonate with you in the comment section below. Now, if it doesn't resonate, you don't have to tell me that because, you know, this is a general reading. So it's not going to resonate with everyone. But this is going to be for Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, Libra signs from May 15th through May 31st. In love. All right, Libra, let's cut the cards and see what we got going here. So Libra, May 31st. Libra, I'm going to do about three spreads for you here just to get, try to cover as many people as possible. Because, you know, everybody's not going through the same thing. Everybody's not dealing with the same thing. So we're going to try to pick up a few energies that you Libras out here in the world are going through to provide some insight and clarity, hopefully, for you. Or to confirm if your hunch was right. Or to give you perspective on a thought or a situation or perspective that you may not have had prior to this reading. So the overall energy is going to be the Two of Wands. Okay. I am using the Golden Thread Tarot. Okay. As you can see, the light hits the gold thread in the cards. It shimmers. It shines. Love these cards. All right. So the Golden Thread Tarot, the overall energy for this reading is the Two of Wands. So we know wands represents Aries, Leo, Sag energy, passion. This is going to represent the two, which is balance, duality, maybe partnership. So since we're talking about love, this overall theme could be about your partnership and how you are going or how things are going between May 15th and May 31st. So as far as your cards are showing, I'm showing, Sword energy in reverse, Queen of Swords in reverse here. And then we have a Five of Swords. And we have a Four of Swords. And we have a Seven of Swords. So we have a lot of air energy going on here, Libra. And this particular spread, it's not looking like you're happy here. We have the Queen of Swords in reverse here. That's telling me that you or your partner, I believe this is you because this is air energy, you are pissed. You are upset. You've been in a situation perhaps where you are ready for something new. Looks like maybe perhaps you were being put in a situation where you were dealing with someone who wasn't honest. Possibly somebody who was juggling you and someone else. I have the Two of Pentacles here. Pentacles represents Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn energy. So perhaps you were in a situation where you were being juggled with someone else, because I do show the Seven of Swords here, which means that there was definitely some terrible things going on here, some distrust, disloyalty, dishonesty, which is why you're probably in the Queen of Swords in reverse energy. I don't blame you. But it looks like you are trying to rest and recoup with the Four of Swords here. Trying to get yourself, back on track from that crazy situation. So yeah, there was definitely. Look at the two cards that are showing up in this spread. So you guys, oh my God, you guys were really dealing with someone who really, wasn't cool. Wasn't cool at all. And that's just putting it nicely. This person was a piece of shit. To be quite honest, treated you like shit. I don't know why or what was going on, but it looks like it could have very well been a third-party energy because we got the Three of Pentacles here, more Taurus Capricorn, Virgo energy, along with the Two of Pentacles. So you could have very well been being in a situation where you were being juggled with another lover. Yeah, this is, your lover did this to you. So this is the Gemini card, okay? So if you're, you could have been dealing with a Gemini, but I do have heavy sword energy here. I have that you walked away. You or your partner walked away. If you were doing this to your partner, you were being really crappy to them, and they walked away. This is Eight of Cups. This is Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces energy. But yeah, somebody walked away. You or your partner walked away. If this would, if they were doing this to you, you walked away. If you were doing this to them, they walked away from you. Yeah, I mean, why wouldn't you walk away from this type of energy? I'm sorry. Seven of Swords, Five of Swords. So this person was just being really ruthless, really crappy. All right, and it took you, it took everything in you to walk away from this person. Yeah, see, you're Libra, I'm so sorry you're going through this. Nine of Swords energy. Stress the hell out from this asshole or this bitch, whoever they are. Yeah, so you, you know, either you've been enlightened with what's going on, or you, you know, decided, because you're probably in the midst of deciding what you want to do here, which is the overall energy of the Two of Wands. Yeah, Ten of Swords. See, you went from the nine to the ten. So you're some, you're pretty much near completion with this, you know, as far as you know, at your wit's end with this nonsense. And hopefully, you know, you're ready to move on and find something better, because this person is really crappy. And if this is you doing this to someone, you got to be careful, because right now Pluto's in retrograde in the house, in the 10th house, the house of your reputation, the house of how people look at you. All right. Also, Saturn is in retrograde in that same house, the 10th house, your reputation, your career, how people see you. So if you're doing this to someone, you know, this could very well come to light. And it may not be a good look for you, but if someone is doing this to you, then, you know, it's Saturn in retrograde. Brings karma, you know, so whatever karma is coming to a person who's doing something like this, it's coming. All right, and if you're doing this, unfortunately, you may have some negative karma coming to you. And see, you got all summer with Pluto in retrograde and Saturn in retrograde, okay? Because Pluto's going to be in retrograde until October. Saturn's going to be in retrograde until September. All right, so this is, you got to watch out. If this is you doing this to someone, all summer, you may very well get this coming back to you. And if they're doing this to you, they're probably going to get this coming back to them, especially if they're doing it, they're doing it to you and they're okay with it, and they think that it's okay, and they're doing it to others on top of that. Like, this is terrible. Let's see what else is going on here. Damn, I just shuffled these cards. Yeah, the Wheel of Fortune in reverse. Okay, so for some reason, maybe you're still in the last spread. We had the Nine of Swords and then the Ten of Swords. So you're still in that Ten of Swords energy, because you haven't completed this cycle out yet. All right, but you're getting there. You're getting there. But look, it, I just shuffled these cards while I was talking to you. You saw me shuffle them, right? Let me tell you what came up again. Queen of Swords in reverse. Five of Swords again. Okay. Now, I'm pulling up Pentacles, Six of Pentacles in reverse. So, obviously, there was no balance there. And maybe this was the person that you were dealing with the Four of Pentacles, them just being very selfish and thinking about themselves and not giving a damn about anybody. All right? And this was somebody that you were in love with, because this is the Lover's card here. And then I have the Five of Wands in reverse. I'm sorry, Five of Swords. I'm sorry, Five of Wands in reverse. So, oh my God, Libra, we have the Five of Swords and the Five of Wands. Man, we got the Page of Pentacles here. So perhaps, you know, there's possibly something new in the horizon, or maybe you just working on a brand new idea that you have in reference to your career, or making some money. And I do see that here, eventually you're going to get to that completion of that, this crazy, crazy situation you're going through. So just keep pushing, Libra. Just keep pushing through. All right? Yeah, Ace of Pentacles. You got something new coming in. Could very well be love, but or it could be you just working on your coins. If it's love, you could have a Cancer, Scorpio. I'm sorry. If it's new, it could be a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn coming in. Yeah, we have the Nine of Cups here. So perhaps you have some new love coming in. I hope so, if that's what you... Because I know you guys love to be in relationships. You guys are love. You know, you guys relate to everybody. You're pretty cool and flexible and fun to be around. So I'm sorry that you're going through all of this. But right now, you might be in a stage where you are looking for love. The Queen of Swords, Queen of Cups energy. Or what this could be is the Cancer... Scorpio, Pisces, that your partner is dealing with. Okay, we got two queens on the board here. Man. Yeah, and so this would have been wish fulfillment for you, because this is Ten of Cups in reverse, which goes drops down to the Nine of Cups. Nine of Cups is wish fulfillment. So this was a relationship that you had with someone, and it was something that you really wanted. It was something that you were into. There was love at some point here. I'm not sure what happened, but we're gonna put another spread here to see what's going on. Libra, I'm so sorry that you are going through this. It's terrible. Whoever this is, I hope you drop them. I hope you drop them, because nobody deserves to be treated like that. Nobody deserves to be treated like that. That's just craziness. Crazy. May 13th, 15th through May 31st. In love. And my Libras. My Libras, they're going through it. Come on, Spirit. You want me to let them know? You wanted me to let them know that, you know, you see what they're going through. You see they're going through hell. Let me know what you want them to do about it. Damn. Now you saw me shuffle these cards. So in the first spread, we had the Three of Pentacles here, because we knew it was a third-party situation going on. And this is the overall energy for this spread here. Now, I just shuffled these cards again. You saw me. We got the Five of Swords again here. Okay, so let's stop and talk about this for a minute, because this came up in all three spreads. All right. Not only did this come up in all three spreads, the World card came up in all three spreads as well. Okay. So the World card is basically saying this is going to be an end to this. You know, it was confirmed. Spirit confirmed it three times in the three spreads. Okay. This is coming to an end. It's coming to an end. It probably has already ended for you, and you're just ready to move forward. And again, we have the Lover's card that came out again. This is the second time it came out of the three spreads we did. We have the Four of Pentacles that came out. This is the second time this has come out in two of the three spreads we did. Someone being selfish, or perhaps this is Spirit telling you, you need to be selfish and guard yourself. All right. This is the second time that the Page of Pentacles came out of the third. This is the third spread here. Okay. So this five here, this Five of Swords here, fives we know represent struggle, change. You know, this is mentally. You're going through this mentally, in your head here. So you're going through the back and forth in your head about what happened, how you got, you know, the Two of Cups in reverse here. And we got the Lover's card. Two of Cups in reverse. And the Lover's. So this is heavy Gemini energy. So you're dealing with somebody who's got Gemini in their chart. Or they are a Gemini. This person could be a Gemini moon. This person is crap. And if Libra, if you're doing this to somebody, like, please, just let them go. Don't drag anybody through the mud like that. That's terrible. Just clarify this Five of Swords. I just want to see what was going on here. So we got the Three of Wands in reverse. Okay, so we know threes represent partnerships, represent creativity, expansion. So there's not going to be any expansion. Wands represent passion and energy. So there's not going to be any growth in this. Okay, in this situation. This situation is over. This is the World card. We just need to let this go. Libra, Libra, Libra. Yeah, again, here's the next card I pulled. I shuffled these cards. So you see, this is the Six of Pentacles in reverse. There's no balance in this relationship. None whatsoever. The Death card. Yes, this is over. This is over. This is Scorpio energy. Definitely over, okay? Libra, you got to move on, okay? You got the Two of Pentacles. You were being juggled. This came up in the last spread, okay? Yeah, Ace of Pentacles. You got something new coming. You got something new coming. You might have a Cancer, I'm sorry, a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn coming your way. Or this is Spirit just telling you, focus on your coin. Focus on your coin. You know, finish, you know, resting and repairing yourself. You know, remove the wool from your eyes. This is over. The situation is done. It is done. There's the Death card. Understand that it's done. Okay? Don't keep beating yourself up about this. Don't keep putting yourself in this situation here to experience this. Okay? This is over. Let this go. All right? So if you're Two of Wands here, the overall energy is for you to decide if you're going to let this go or not. Two major arcanas here telling you that this is a wrap. No, actually three. Because here's the Two of Cups in reverse. Actually, this isn't a major arcana, but this is just back up here, letting you know this is over. All right? This is over. Cut it off. King of Swords energy. Cut it short. Okay? Here's the Hierophant in reverse. Nothing is coming out of this. There's nothing serious or traditional. You know, if anything, this is going to keep going on, and this is not a natural relationship. This is not something normal. This is not something that people should be dealing with or going through. All right? Ace of Cups in reverse. No new love is coming. All right? This is Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces energy. No, nothing's coming. Nothing's coming to this. Okay? Ten of Pentacles in reverse. Nothing's coming to this. All right, let me do another spread for you, because this is not cool. Now, I done shuffled these cards each time, at least four times in between spreads. Okay. Libra, I'm sorry you have to go through this if this is you dealing with this nonsense. Please cut that bitch or that asshole off. Cut them off. They are not worth your time, your energy, and effort. And trust me, once you cut them off, Pluto and Saturn are going to take care of them. Trust me, they got all summer. All summer to deal with that issue. You deserve better. You totally deserve better. And there's nothing wrong with you wanting better. Nothing wrong with you wanting better. Now, I know you may have kids. You know, there may be some emotion tied to this, but you know, one thing my mom always told me is when you get tired, you're tired. And I know you're tired. Spirit knows you're tired, too. Kind of message you got for me, Spirit, here for Libra. Okay, let's see. All right, so again, overall energy, Three of Pentacles in reverse. Okay, so looks like you brought this to it. You're bringing this to an end. Some of you have been through this situation and now are at the very tail end of it, like we were in the last spread. But here is a Queen of Cups in reverse. Okay? So this could be you taking on this energy and you're heartbroken. Okay? And I could understand that. There is not going to be a new beginning with this. This is the Ace of Wands in reverse. Okay? It looks as though this person has decided to choose someone else besides you. Okay? I know this was someone that was a soulmate with the Six of Cups here. But this is there's some secrets here. There's things that you're not aware of. Okay? And here's the Death card in reverse. What else we got going here? Okay, yeah. So the King of Pentacles in reverse. This is the slowest moving knight in the deck. If he's coming, he's coming, but he's taking his time. In the reverse, he's not even coming. So if you're dealing with a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, nothing serious is coming of this. You're dealing with a Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. Nothing is coming of this. If you're dealing with a Gemini, Libra, I'm sorry, Aries, Leo, or Sag, nothing is coming of this. Here's the Ace of Wands in reverse. And we got the King of Pentacles in reverse as well. Okay, so yeah, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn energy. Nothing is happening with this here. We got the Knight of Cups. Let's clarify that and see what that's about. Okay, we got the Ten of Pentacles in reverse, which is the Nine of Pentacles. So this could be wish fulfillment here, but let's see what else is coming. Yeah, so we got the Seven of Pentacles. So yeah, it looks as though you're waiting for love to come in. You're waiting for your just due. And you definitely deserve it with what you've been through. And the higher power is saying, okay, you let that go, then this is going to be a good thing. Okay, there's the Wheel of Fortune. But you got to let that nastiness go. So then that way love will come in. As soon as you let that go and move forward from that, you're going to get love coming in. Okay? Because you deserve love. Yeah, here's the Two of Pentacles in reverse. As soon as you let that go, that juggling go, you'll be fine. Being juggled, knowing that you're being juggled. This is the Two of Pentacles in reverse. Okay? So you know about it, or it was in the past. And here's Temperance in reverse. You're going to need to get balance in the relationship. And if you can't get balance, then you need to leave it alone. Or you need to get balance within yourself so that you can move forward from this, or get balance in yourself now that you have moved forward so that you could find love. Yeah, you've been enlightened. Here's the Hangman. You've been enlightened. You know what it is. Okay, your intuition is talking to you and letting you know what's going on. And the Divine is talking to you through these cards. Here's the Four of Cups. So it looks as though somebody could have very well just been playing around, bored with this situation. Oh my goodness. King of Swords, yes. Here we go again. So yes, Spirit is just telling you again in this spread, cut this short. Use logic. Use intuition. This is you. This is your energy. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius energy. Okay, coming in strong as the King of Swords. So you know this needs to be cut short. All right, because if you want wish fulfillment, that's what you're going to have to do. You got to leave this alone so that you can move forward to get your Two of Wands. Okay, yeah, see the Chariot card's coming up here. This is Cancer energy heavy. All right, so this means that if you're even going to, I know it's going to be difficult for you to move forward and let that go, but you can do this. You can do this, Libra. You can definitely do this. All right. And here is Five of Wands. You don't need all this drama. Like, this is too much. This is a lot for anybody to go through, Libra. Yeah. So you want something traditional. You want something where you are going to feel that there's equal give and take and that there's equal balance. But the situation you were in is not that. And it's putting you in a situation where you're constantly questioning your moral capacity, questioning your intuition, questioning your gut. This, you're all in your head with this. This is sword energy. You're all in your head with this. All right? And then we have the Six of Swords. All right? So even if this person tries to come back to you with all you've been through, I don't even need to say it. The card says it. Eight of Cups. Walk away, Libra. Walk away. So that you can get new love. Okay? New love is going to come in once you walk away. All right, Libra, my heart is here for you. All right, let me know if this resonated with you. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to touch back in with you guys at the beginning of June and see what's going on for you. Peace and blessings, Libra. Take care. I'll see you in June.